10 celestial events happening this year. Hello guys, and welcome back to the channel. Event number 1. From April 15th to April 29th, we'll be seeing Lyrid meteor shower in a clear sky. It's of rare occasions and can surprise viewers with as many as 100 meteors in an hour. Event number 2. From April 15th to May 27th, we'll be seeing another meteor, the ETA Aquarid Meteors. The shower is known for its fast meteors that leave long, glowing trails. It can travel up to about 148,000 miles per hour into Earth's atmosphere. It was last observed in 1986. Event number 3. From July 14th to September 1st, Perseid meteor shower will light up the skies with bright, frequent meteors. Long tails will light up the sky at rates about 50 to 100 per hour. It was last seen in 2021. Event number 4. On August 31st, a super blue moon will occur, and people will notice that the full moon appears slightly larger and brighter than usual. We'll be seeing 4 super moons this year. Event number 5. From September 26th to November 22nd, we'll be seeing Orionids. While the Orionids may not be as powerful as the Perseids or the Geminids, they're still a spectacle worth observing. When observed from a dark area, viewers can witness around 10 to 20 meteors every hour at the height of the shower, which occurs around October 22nd's morning. Event number 6. On October 14th, we'll be witnessing an annular solar eclipse. The forthcoming annular solar eclipse will be observable from the southwestern region of the United States. Solar eclipses occur when the moon is situated between the Earth and the sun, although this year, as the moon will not entirely obscure the sun, viewers in specific areas will witness a bright, luminous ring, commonly known as the Ring of Fire. The duration of this annular solar eclipse can extend up to 12 minutes and 30 seconds. Event number 7. On October 28th, we'll witness a partial lunar eclipse. Last year, the United States observed 2 total lunar eclipses. A total lunar eclipse is experienced when the Earth's shadow completely obscures the moon's surface. Conversely, a partial eclipse takes place when the moon only partially passes through the Earth's dark shadow or umbra. Another kind of eclipse is called a penumbral lunar eclipse, which is more subtle and happens when the Earth's fainter outer shadow, known as the penumbra, falls on the moon. The penumbral eclipse will only be viewable from the east coast of the United States. During this event, the moon will remain below the horizon throughout the partial eclipse, which will commence at 3:35 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time and terminate at 4:52 p.m. However, if one pays close attention, one may still observe the Earth's faint penumbra on the moon's surface after it rises in its region. The penumbral eclipse will culminate at 6:26 p.m. Eastern. Event number 8. From November 19th to December 24th, we'll witness Geminid meteor shower. The Geminids are a well-liked meteor shower and one of the final showers of the year. This event is recognized for its fast-moving meteors, which can travel at speeds of 78,000 miles per hour, more than 40 times quicker than a speeding bullet. Event number 9. On March 1st, we'll witness Venus-Jupiter conjunction. A conjunction in astronomy arises when a planet seems to be near to a moon, another planet, or a star. Such conjunctions occur with some frequency and do not hold any significant astronomical significance, but they are a pleasant spectacle to observe. Event number 10. On February 2nd, Comet C 2022-E3 comes close to Earth. Comet C 2022-E3 will pass by our planet at a distance of approximately 26.4 million miles. This is the closest approach it's made to Earth since the time when Homo sapiens started migrating from Africa to settle in Europe and Asia. Thanks for watching. For more amazing facts, events, and details, subscribe to our channel. And please like and share our videos.